This conference will now be recorded.
So let's start. If you're having any issues in the audio or video, please let me know. I'm having some network issue from my end. Right. Okay. So in the last week, we have discussed about what modularization techniques. As part of that, we have seen how to work with subroutines, include programs and function models. So the last concept we discussed is what? Function models. Okay. So we have seen how to create the function models and how to call the function models. Okay. So we have seen how to create our own function models, that is custom function models. What are the function models we create? We call them as what? Custom function models. But as part of your projects, you'll be working with what? Both standard function models, as well as we are responsible for creating what? Our own function models. So standard function models means what? Those function models are defined by what? SAP itself. As a developer, we need to call that particular function model. So before calling the function model, as we know, we need to check the signature of the function model. That is, we should know what are the import parameters, what are the return parameters, whether the parameters are passed by whether the parameters are passed by value or by reference, whether they are optional parameters or mandatory parameters, okay, or whether they are having any default values. So we need to check the signature and call the function models. Now today what I'll do is we will see how to use the standard function models. How to use the standard function models. So standard function models, what? Defined by what? Defined by SAP itself. Okay. And called by what? Developer. Okay. So the definition is provided by SAP itself. The signature, the implementation is provided by SAP itself. We are only responsible for what? Calling the function model. Okay. So my requirement is here. This is my ABAP program. Okay, whenever I execute this ABAP program, I should get a selection screen. This selection screen should contain some input values. A drop down kind of thing. Okay, so I require what? One drop down. Okay, so drop down means what? Where the user can select what? Required values. Whenever I click on the drop down should be what? Extended. Okay, so assume that this is something what? Select a course, and this drop down should contain some values. Okay, it should contain some values like what? Core ABAP. Okay. Oops, ABAP. Excuse me, please.
Hello. Partha, already have sent the ID. So everyone has connected. You restart the system and try.
Oops, ABAP, a core ABAP, oops, ABAP, and what? Something cross app. So they are the what? Drop down values. Okay, so this particular drop down, whenever I click on the drop down, it should contain some of these three values. Okay, something like this. So these are my what? Drop down values. These are drop down values. Okay, then what I want on the selection screen only. Okay, I'll take one push button. Already we know how to design the push button. Whenever I click on this button, whenever I click on this button, okay, suppose assume that I have selected this value. What is that? I have selected the OOPSUB app, for example. Okay, if I select the OOPSUB app, what should happen? When on click of this button, it should display me the selected value. Okay, so selected value is what? OOPSUB app, something like this. This is my requirement. This is your output screen. Nothing but what? List processing screen. So here the main focus is what? The main focus is how to design the selection screen with what? Drop-down values. How to design the selection screen containing a list box. This is nothing but what? Drop-down list box. Whenever I click on the drop-down list box, it should show me the list of what? Values. So when do we go for a drop-down? When you want to show some fixed set of values in the form of drop-down, when you want the user to select any value in the runtime, okay? When you want to select the user to select any value in the runtime, we'll go for what? Drop-down. So here our agenda is what? How to design the drop-down, how to associate the values with the drop-down, and how to identify the selected value in the drop-down. Okay, so this is on click of what? Button. Okay, on click of button, I should get the list processing screen which should contain this particular drop-down. This is the requirement. Okay, so let me just save this. So here, this can be achieved by using what? A standard function model. Okay, so that is the reason we are discussing that. One second, please. Done. Okay, so now I'll go to ABAP editor. Let me give the object name. Last object is 32, so I'll give 33. Drop down list box in what? Selection screen. Type of program is what? Executable program. I'll save it in the local object. So now already we know how to generate the selection screen. Selection screen nothing but what? Input screen. Okay. So how do we generate the selection screen? One of the statement is what? Parameters. Okay. So assume that I'll give the parameter name as something p underscore course. Try to understand. P underscore course of something 20 type what? C. P underscore course of 20 type C. So when I execute this, no syntax error. When I execute, done. What happened? I got the selection screen, but it is generating what? As input field. Input field means what? The user can enter only what? A single value. But I want to what? Convert this input field to a drop down list box. Okay, so what I have to do here, p underscore course of 20 type C, here you have to use the addition as a list box. We have to use the addition what? As list box. Okay, so when I say as a list box, let's see what happens. Save it, check for the syntax error. Yeah, when I use as what? Addition as list box, I got an error. What is that? The as a list box addition can only be used with what? Visible length. The as a list box addition can only be used with visible length. So it seems that whenever I use this as list box addition, I need to use another addition called as what? Visible length itself. Okay. So what I'll do is, let me keep this for your reference. Okay. So this is giving me what? Syntax error. Okay. Syntax error. Now I'll say parameters as list box. I'll use what? Visible length. Let me give it as something what? 10. Okay. I'll give the visible length as something 10 or 12, whatever it is. I get as 10. Save it, or let me do it as 15. Save it, check it. Yeah, no syntax error. Let me check when I say F8. Good. Okay, so I got the selection screen which contains what drop down list. So you can see the arrow pointer, this is indicating that it is a drop down. Okay, so when I click on this, I don't have any values. So what I have to do, I need to associate some input values. I need to associate some drop down values with this particular list box. What values you want to associate? Core something, some fixed set of values like core ABAP, OOPS ABAP, and what? Cross app. So let's see how to do it. Okay, so any questions up to this point? Okay, so we are trying to prepare the list box. What is the name of the list box here? P underscore course is the name of the list box. Every element on the selection screen should have what? One should have some unique identification. What is the name of the drop down list box? P underscore course. Okay, so since I said as list box, it is showing me it as what? List box. So what is the next requirement now? This drop down should be associated with what? Some set of values. What is the requirement here? I need to associate how many values? Three values with the drop down. Okay, so already we know whenever I execute the program, before displaying the selection screen to the user, two events gets triggered. Okay, already in the initial classes we discussed, before showing the selection screen to the user for the first time, two events are triggered. What are they? Initialization event and at selection screen output. The first event triggered is what? Initialization event. So what I'll do is I will handle the event called as initialization event. Inside that initialization event, I'll write the logic to associate some fixed set of values with my drop down. Okay, so what are the fixed set of values? Your core ABAP, OOPS ABAP, and cross apps. Now one more point you have to understand here, every value in the drop down will be associated with some key. Okay, so assume that the key is what? K1. Another key is what? K2, something like this. K1, K2, and what? K3. K1, K2, and what? K3. So I repeat once again, every value in the drop down list box, okay, should be associated with the key. So I want to show how many values to the user? Three values. These are the values which are shown to the user. But internally, every value in the drop down should be associated with the key. So what is the purpose of that key? You'll understand going forward. In the simple terminology, I can say this key is used for identifying the selected value. Means, suppose if I select OOPS ABAP in the runtime, okay, this OOPS ABAP will be selected in the drop down, will be shown to the user in the drop down. But internally, this K2 will be captured in the list box. What is the name of the list box in my case? P underscore course is the name of the list box. Okay, suppose if I choose core ABAP, what is the key of that particular core ABAP? K1. This K1 will go and sit in what? That particular list box name internally. It is not, keys are not shown to the user. For the user, only the drop down values are shown. Okay, but internally, for the developer perspective, to identify the selected value, we have to compare with what? Key. Means that key will be assigned to this name of the list box internally. But what is my initial requirement here? I need to associate them some list of values to this particular drop down. So where I should write that logic? In the initialization event, because that is the first event triggered before the selection, whenever the selection screen is what? Displayed. Done. So in the initialization event, I need to write the logic to associate the values. So how do we write these values? Is see, this is important. So far we have called what? Custom function models. We have created our own function models and we have called our own function models. Now we are going to start with what? Standard function model. So in ABAP, whenever you have the drop down requirement, whenever you want to generate the drop down with the list of values, there is one standard function model for that. So where we can see the function models in SE 37, function builder. Okay, so if I go to function builder SE 37, then inside this function here I need to provide the name of the function model. What is the name of the function model? There is one dedicated function model for that, vrm underscore set underscore values. Understood? See, there is no particular place where I can go and say check that for drop down you have to use this function model, for some other functionality I have to use this one. No, okay, it will come by what exposure only. So as I told you in the initial and earlier sessions, as an ABAP consultant, we'll be using some 70 to 80 function models very frequently for most of the requirements. So one of the function model is what? VRM underscore set underscore values. So what you have to remember now onwards is, whenever you have the drop down requirement in ABAP, whenever you want to construct the drop down values, we have to go for what? A function model called as VRM underscore set underscore values. So since it is a standard function model, it is not starting with Z or Y. Okay, so I cannot modify it, I cannot change the signature. So it, since it is a standard one, I'll just display it. So what is my job now? I need to call this function model to associate the values. Okay, so before calling the function model, what you have to do, we need to check the, we need to analyze the signature of the function model so that we will understand what parameters you have to pass, what data types you have to pass, what are optional parameters, what are mandatory parameters, all those things. So in the import section, import means while calling becomes what? Export. So let me go to import section. Yes, in the import section there are two parameters. One is the one parameter name is ID, another parameter is what? Values. Both these parameters, optional checkbox is not selected, which means what? It is mandatory. Which means what? It is mandatory, means compulsorily you need to pass the values. Okay, so what type of values you have to pass? What is this ID here? ID is of type what? VRM underscore ID. So by looking at this type, I am unable to understand whether it is character, integer, float, date, time, string, I don't know. So let me double click on this and check what is the data type I need to pass. So when I double click on this, yes, VRM underscore ID is of type what? VRM underscore value hyphen text it seems. VRM underscore ID is of what type? VRM underscore value hyphen text. Again, by looking at this, I don't know what is this. Let me double click on this. Yes, VRM underscore value is a types declaration. Already we know the concept of a types declaration. To provide the template of the fields, we'll go for types. So inside this types declaration, they are referring to a field called as text, which is what here? Character of what? 80. Character of what? 80. So what is the understanding now? Let me go back. So I understood that this parameter is expecting what? A character value of size what? 80. Max size is what? 80. How do I know that? If I double click on this, it has taken the control to something called as type group. We'll understand what is type group going for it. It is taking the control to something called as type group called as VRM. Inside the type group, they are referring to one declaration, VRM underscore value, which is of type VRM underscore value hyphen text. If I double click on this again, VRM underscore value is a type declaration, text is what? Character of what? 80. Done. So I need to pass character value, it says. But what character? Whether you'll pass A, B, C, A, we don't know. So if you see the description here, what is the short text here? Name of what? Value set. This parameter is expecting the name of what? Value set. Name of value set means, in our selection screen, what is the field which is going to hold the set of values? This is the field. What is the name of the field in my program? P underscore core. So understanding is, this parameter is expecting the name of the list box. This parameter is expecting the name of the list box, which is going to hold the set of what? Values. Okay, so that is the analysis. Understood? By double clicking on this, I understood that I need to pass character value. But what character, we don't know. So they give some description. What is that? It is expecting the name of value set. Value set means which is holding the set of values, collection of values. Okay, so in our context, in our program, what is the field which is going to hold the name of those set of values in the selection screen, p underscore what course. So I need to pass p underscore course as a character value. Done. What is the other parameter here? Values. It is of type what? VRM underscore values. Values is of type VRM underscore values. They didn't give any short description. Again, by looking at this, I don't know what I have to pass. Let me double click on this. Okay. What is this here? VRM underscore values. Type of VRM underscore occurs what? Zero. What is the comment here? Table of what? Values. So now onwards, remember, wherever we see occurs keyword, you have to understand that is what? Internal table. Here also they can see the comment here. Table of values. So I can say that it is an internal table. Internal table of type what? How can you say this is internal table? Now one must remember blindly. Wherever we have occurs keyword, you have to understand that it is an internal table. Okay, so I need to prepare an internal table of type what? VRM underscore values. So in order to prepare the internal table, I should know the fields of that internal table. So what are the fields here? If I double click on this, okay, if I double click on this, see once again, VRM underscore values is of type what? VRM underscore value. Okay, let me double click on this VRM underscore value. VRM underscore is a types declaration, right? So this types is having how many fields? Key, which is character, text, which is again what? Character. So the internal table, whatever you are going to prepare, contains how many fields? Two fields, key and what? Text. Already we know the standard way of creating the internal table. You'll create the types declaration. Based on the types declaration, you'll create the internal table. So they also done the same thing. Okay, VRM underscore value, the types declaration. Based on that, they are preparing the internal table. But the syntax we know is what? VRM underscore values, type table of VRM. Wherever we use table keyword, we are assuming that as an internal table, but this is an old syntax which is not followed in the current project. Still, there are some developers who are using occurs keyword, but it is absolute. Okay, going forward, this syntax is not supported. So whatever you have followed, you follow that only. But since this is an old function model, this is an old code which is already implemented by SAP years back. Okay, so they have used the old syntax for declaring the internal table. So the blind understanding is wherever we see occurs keyword now onwards, you understand that as what? Internal table. And we have to prepare an internal table of type what? VRM underscore value. We have to prepare an internal table of type VRM underscore value. Okay, which has got how many fields? Two fields, key and what? Text. Okay, so these are two mandatory parameters I have to pass. What is that? First, I need to pass the name of the drop down list box. Then I need to pass the internal table. So before calling this function model only, I need to prepare the internal table. When do we go for internal table? Whenever you want to store more than one record, you'll go for what? Internal table. Here also, this is nothing but a set of values, collection of values, no? Nothing but what? More than one value. So that's why we have to prepare an internal table of what type? VRM underscore values. Okay, and then pass that internal table as a value to this particular parameter. Done. Then export. Okay, already we have seen export parameters are always optional. If you are interested, you can import, otherwise you can ignore. But let me check whether we have any return parameters. So I'll go for export. There are no export parameters for this particular function model. Let me check changing. Changing, already we know, while calling becomes what? Changing only. Remains what? Changing. I'll click on this. Nothing is there in the changing. Okay. Tables, we have not seen any example, but I told that whatever is there in the tables, you have to understand that as what? Internal table. Okay. This is also internal table. This is also internal table. Okay. So, but whatever is there in the tables also, blindly you have to understand that is an internal table. How can you say this is an internal table? By double click on this, I understood that it is having what? Occurs keyword. Occurs is nothing but what? Internal table. This is one thing. And whatever you have in the table section, you have to understand that is what? Internal table. But anyhow, in this function model, I don't have any tables parameters. So let us not focus on this now. When we going forward, When we come across a function model with tables, we will focus on this. Exceptions, a function model might contain exceptions. Na? Last class, I believe I gave an example on exception. If exception is not handled, there's a possibility of the there's a possibility that the program execution may lead to runtime error. So if I go to exceptions, yes, it is, might raise an exception with the name what, so and so. So our job is we have to handle it. Source code means the logic is defined by what? SAP itself. Don't try to understand. We cannot understand. No need to understand. Okay, so this is the logic defined by what? SAP itself. Our job is only to check the signature of the function model. So by looking at the signature, I understand that there are only two mandatory import parameters. One parameter is expecting the name of the dropdown. Another parameter is expecting an internal table of what type? VRM underscore values. So let me prepare internal table. Okay, this declaration is of what type? It is of type what? VRM underscore value. So based on this VRM underscore value, I need to prepare an internal table. Right? So any questions so far, please ask me. Done. So let me prepare it. So in the initialization event, I need to prepare that value. So before that, I require an internal table. Na? So data, how to declare internal table, already we know. What is the standard way of declaring internal table? First, you have to create the types declaration. Based on the types declaration, you have to prepare the internal table. But anyhow, in this case, the types declaration is provided by SAP itself. Na? What is that? If I double click on this, what is the type name? VRM underscore value. If I double click, what is this? Types only. Na? So based on this types declaration, let us prepare the internal table. So what else? Data, some name. Generally, you'll start the internal with what? T underscore. So T underscore values. Type what? Table of what? What is the type name? VRM underscore value. I have not declared this type. This is a type which is given by SAP itself and which is available as part of the type group what? VRM. Okay, done. Okay, so I declare the internal table. Then I require a work area. Na? So how do you prepare? W underscore value type. What is the type name? VRM underscore value. When I do syntax check, I don't have any errors. Okay, I am following our standard approach. We will declare the internal table based on the types declaration. So far, we have created our own types declaration. Based on the types declaration, we prepared the internal work area. But in this case, I am referring to the standard type provided by what? SAP itself. Where is the standard type is declared? It is declared inside something called as type group. So I am using the component of this type group. I am using the component of this type group in my program. Just like in the earlier week, in the last week, whenever we use the components of any include program, we have to include that include program in the current program by using what keyword? Include keyword. Similarly, whenever we are using the components of a type group, whenever we are using the components of a type group in your program, we need to declare that particular type group. Okay, but in this case here, even if I do syntax check, I am not getting any errors. But if you do the same thing in the older versions, if you're practicing in 6.0 or less than that, you may get an error saying that VRM underscore value is what? Unknown. You may get an error. VRM underscore value is what? Unknown. So if you get an error, what you have to do? You have to declare the type group. How do you declare the type group? You have to use a keyword called as type pools. Type pools. This is a component which is part of which type group? VRM. VRM. So just say type pools VRM. In this case, even if I don't declare also, it is working fine. So required in what? 6.0 and before versions. Okay, this is HP 7. Okay, so I need not declare that type group explicitly. But if you're practicing in the older versions, when I do syntax check, you may get an error. If you get that error, to avoid that error, you declare this type group. Okay, but in this case, none. Right. So now in the initialization event, yeah, what I have to do? I need to prepare the values. Instead of writing the logic directly, I'll just try to modularize my program. So I'll just call one subroutine, perform. Already we know how to call the subroutine, perform. I'll give the subroutine name as something, prepare drop down. Some meaningful subroutine name I'm giving. How to define the subroutine form and what? End form. Where do we define the subroutine? At the end of the program. So somewhere here, I'll say form, end form, or when I double click on this also, it is saying that subroutine so and so does not exist. Create the object. Yes. I'll create that in the main program, in the current program. Continue. Done. So it has, these are all comments. Yeah. Form and form. So what I have to do now? I have to prepare the internal table now. What is the standard way of preparing the internal table? If you are not retrieving it from database, you have to fill the data in the work area. From work area, we have to use append or insert statement to write it to internal table. So before I start using the work area, clear w underscore value, w underscore value hyphen. It is a what type? VRM underscore value. VRM underscore value contains what fields? Key and what? Text. Key and what? Text. I'll say key is equal to, what are the keys you want to give? K1, K2, K3. You can give any keys, any names. I'll give it as what? K1. This is my key for the first value. W underscore value hyphen. What is the next field in my types declaration? Text it seems. So I'll say hyphen text is equal to, you give the value whatever you want. So I'll give it as score abab. Then I'll say append what? W underscore value to T underscore what? Values. Repeat this process. For n number of values, K2, I'll say what? Oops, again, we should not try to understand what is clear, what has happened. That story is over. Don't focus on those things now. Okay? Hope everyone has practiced it. Equal to K3, I'll give it as something, cross apps. Done. Some values. Okay? Why I'm giving in single quotes? Because both the fields are what type? Character. That's the reason I'm enclosing in single quote. So, I am done with preparing the internal table, which has got how many values? 3 values. What are the values? Core abap, oops abap, and cross abs. What are the keys associated with them? K1, K2, and K3. Done. Save it. After executing the subroutine, control comes to the next statement. So here I'll say, what is my next job now? I need to associate these values to my dropdown. How do we associate? You need to call this function module. What is that function module? VRM underscore set underscore what values. So I'll say here, okay, if I prepare the internal table, what is the internal table name? T underscore what values. If T underscore values is not initial, not initial means what? Not empty. Okay, if it is not empty, what I have to call the function module. I can directly call here, call function I can say, but I want to modularize that. So I'll say perform. I'm calling another subroutine, display what? Drop down. Understood? I'm trying to modularize my program. Each functionality I'm trying to put in a separate block. Okay, preparing the drop down values I enclose in a subroutine, displaying that sub drop down I'm enclosing that inside another block, inside another subroutine. Perform display drop down. Let me double click on this. Does not exist. Create the object. Yes, I'll choose the main program. I don't want to create a separate include. I will define the subroutine in the main program only. Continue. So at the end, I need to display it. How do you display it now? I need to call the function model. How do you call it? Call function so and so. Instead of me typing that, I can make use of the pattern to generate the signature. I'll go to pattern. What is the function model name here? What is the name? VRM underscore set underscore what values. VRM underscore set underscore values. Continue. Then you can see here, import has become what? Export. Import has become export. And then I don't have any other export changing tables, but I'm having what? Exceptions. What is the one of the exception? ID underscore illegal names. What is the meaning? If this exception is raised, it seems that size of bar C is set to what? 1. If some other exception is raised, it is indicated by what? Others keyword. At that time, size of bars is what? 2 it seems. Okay, ID is equal to, what is this ID? What we understood about the ID? It is expecting the name of the dropdown. In my context, in our context, what is the name of the dropdown list box? P underscore what? Course. So I'll say ID is equal to what? P underscore what? Course. P underscore course values is equal to, what is the internal table? I have to pass the internal table. In my context, what is the internal table? T underscore what? Values. Done. Then I want to handle the exception also. If you don't handle the exception, what happens if the exception is raised? It leads to runtime error. So I'll say exceptions. I'll uncomment this. ID underscore illegal equal to 1, others equal to 2. Here I'll check the size of RC status manually. Here I'm giving the period. So from year to year, it is only what? One statement. So I'll write the logic. If what? Size of RC is equal to 1, I'll just give the message. What is that? Illegal drop down list box name. Type what? Information message. Type information message. Then I'll say else if size of RC is equal to what? 2. I don't want the runtime error. Instead of runtime error, you will get this message. Message, I'll give something what? Unknown error. Type what? I. End if. Done. That's it. Okay. Let me save it. Check for the syntax error. No errors. Active errors. Done. Over. Okay. Done. So what happens when I execute, when I start the execution of the program, what is the first event triggered? Initialization event. Okay, what is the statements in this? First, I'm calling this subroutine, control jumps to subroutine. Inside this subroutine, I'm preparing the internal table which contains the drop down values. So after executing this subroutine, my internal will contain three values. Then I'm checking if the internal table is not blank, not empty. I'm calling another subroutine. Inside that subroutine, I'm calling the standard function module by passing the appropriate parameters. Done. Okay, let me execute this. Okay, here you can see ID I gave in single quotes, this ID in single quotes. Wherever you are passing the name, it is clearly saying name. That name should always be enclosed in what? Uppercase in single quotes. But whereas here, this is an internal table. The second parameter is what? Internal table. Okay, I need to refer to the data of that. So whenever you are referring to the data, I should not give the single quotes. If you are referring to the name of any variable, you have to give what? In single quotes. If you are referring to the data of that variable, we should not give single quotes. Okay, so when I execute now, let me check whether I'll get the drop down or not. I'll click on this. Good. I'm having what? Three values. Core app, oops app, and cross apps. The keys are not shown to the user. Keys will not be shown to the end user. Keys are for what? Internal identification to identify the selected value in the drop-down list box. Done. Okay. So when I select this oops app, I got oops app. When I select this cross apps, I got cross apps. Okay. So if I select oops app, what happened? The key will come and sit in the list box internally. Okay, we'll see that. So before going to that, any questions, please ask me. Requires practice, otherwise it will be difficult. Okay, so what is my next requirement here? My selection screen should also contain a push button. Already we know how to design the push button, the selection screen. So what I'll do, somewhere here, selection screen, I'll say skip to, I'll create one button. Okay, how do you create? Already we know that selection screen, push button, refer to the initial classes, push button. From which position you want to start the push button? I want to start from 8th position. What is the width you want to give for the push button? 15, I'll say. Okay, what is the name of the push button? B1. Every push button will have a function code. Now, how to associate the function code? User command. Okay, I'll give the function code as what? FC1. Any name you can give, I give the function code as FC1. Let me check whether the button is appearing or not. Skip to means what? It will skip two lines on the selection screen. Then I'm constructing the push button. What is the name of the push button? P1. Starts from which position? 8th position. How many spaces you are reserving for the push button? 15 spaces. What is the function code of that push button? FC1. So when I execute, yes, I got the push button. Okay, so let me give more space. Okay, something like this. Okay, done. Also 32. So that it will be aligned properly. Done. Something like this. This button should have a label. What is the label you want to show here? Identify. Okay. So where do we initialize them? In the initialization event. So somewhere in the initialization event. Okay. This entire thing is part of what? Initialization only. Okay. I'll say B1 is equal to, I'll give the text as something what? Identify. Something. Okay. Save it, check it, done, activate when I execute, done. Okay, now what is the requirement? If I click on this, I'll click on the button, the selected value should be displayed in the output screen. So already we know, whenever we click on the push button, what is the event triggered? The event triggered is what? On the selection screen. At selection screen is the event. Whenever we click on the push button on the selection screen, the event triggered is at selection screen. Please refer to the initial classes. So I need to handle another event now. What is that event? At selection screen. So I'll say at selection screen. Already we know this. The function code of that button will come and sit in the system field what? SciUCOM in uppercase. Case SciUCOM when what? FC1 do so and so. End case. End case. Okay. Done. So now auto identify the selected value. What is the name of the list box? P underscore course. The name of the drop down list box is P underscore course. So I'll say if P underscore course equal to K1, okay, do so and so. Else if P underscore course is equal to what? K2, do so and so. Else if P underscore course is equal to what? K3, do so and so. Else if none is selected, I'll just give an if. Okay, so if P underscore course equal to K1 means which value you have to selected? Oops, core abap. So I can use write statement or I'll use a message statement. Message. Okay, what I'll do, I'll just give a message. Core abap is selected. Core abap is selected. Type information message. Instead of using write statement, I'm using the message. Then if it is K2, I'll say what? Oops abap. If it is K3, I'll say what? Cross apps. Cross apps is selected. Okay. If it is nothing, I'll just give a message. I'll try to give a message. What? None is what? Selected. Let me check first, then I'll explain. When I execute, I have selected nothing. Good. None is selected. I'll select oops abap. Good. What I got? Oops abap is selected. I'll choose CoreABAP. CoreABAP is selected. I'll choose CrossApps. CrossApps is selected. I'll choose nothing. None is selected. Good. Working fine. So what is the understanding? Whenever I click on the button, what is the event triggered? At selection screen. At selection screen. But before that, the important concept is, what are the values you have shown to the user? CoreABAP, OOPSABAP, and CrossApps. If I select OOPSABAP, what is the key of this OOPSABAP when I prepare the values? K2 na. This K2 will go and sit in the drop down list box internally. I cannot see it. If you debug, we can see it. You can observe here. Quickly understand this. I am putting the breakpoint there, initialization event. I'll put the breakpoint in at selection screen also. Just try to understand. I'm putting the breakpoint for both the events. When I start the execution, what is the first event triggered? Initialization. So let me say F8, done. It is stopping where? Initialization. I'll say F5. I'm calling one subroutine. Yeah, what you are doing in the subroutine, you're trying to prepare the internal table. So if you see T underscore values, it is initial. As of it is initial. So I'll say F5, done. One value is appended. Two values are appended. Okay. Third value is getting appended. Done. So if you see, it has got how many entries? Three entries. If I double click on this, yes. What are the key? Key is K1, K2, K3. What is the text? CoreABAP, OOPSABAP, and CrossApp. If it is not initial, I am calling the subroutine, F5. I am calling the function model. If I say F5 now, control jumps to the definition of this function model. Okay, there is no meaning in debugging the logic of this function model. It is already developed by SAP. Our job is only to call. How they have written it is out of our discussion. You do not understand. Okay. Understood. So I don't want to debug that. I don't want to debug this function model logic. So if I say F5, control goes to the definition of the function model. I don't want that. I want to skip it. How do you skip it? F6. Done. I'll say F8. Done. Okay. Now you can see I got the list of values. Now I'll select observer. So internally, when I select observer, what happens internally? The key of this value will go and sit in the list box internally. So internally, what is the value of P underscore course? K2. That is the understanding. Internally, the value of P underscore course is what? K2. Now, if I click on this button, what is the event triggered? At selection screen. Now, see here. What is the value of button function code? FC1. That is Captain Sayukam. See the value of P underscore course? What is this? K2. So, internally, in that drop down list box, what is getting captured? The key of the selected value. So, when I say F5, control goes to the first if block. Condition not satisfied, control comes to the second else if block. Yes, condition is satisfied, it will try to prompt the message. I'll say fit, I got oops of episode selected. This is a way to prepare the drop down and to identify the selected value. Any questions, please ask. Okay, I'll try to share the recording by afternoon. Refer to this practice, because going forward we'll be using many function models. So blindly we cannot use the function models. We need to check the signature, understand the signature, and then pass the appropriate values to that particular parameters. Okay, so now onwards, wherever you'll get the drop down requirement in selection screen and going forward module pull screen, the function model you have to use is what? VRM underscore set underscore what? Values. Done? Any questions, anyone? Right then. Okay, so I'll wind off. Tomorrow we'll start using other function models, and we'll try to interact with what? Database. See, I'll plan accordingly, I'll discuss. Don't worry about the future topics. Okay, done. So I'll wind up then. We'll continue tomorrow.